Hi and welcome to the display review of Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge, company's new flagship smartphone in 2016. Galaxy S7 Edge is based on Samsung Display's Super AMOLED screen that is curved on both sides, making it unique on the market. Samsung Display holds more than 90% of market share in OLED screens for mobiles, and it is reportedly in talks with Apple to supply OLED panels next year. Screen is 5.5-inch in diagonal, with physical resolution of 2560 by 1440, 16:9 aspect ratio. It is 8-bit, capable of displaying up to 16.7 million different colors. For more specs, check links in the description. As with iPhone SE review, I used SpectraCal C6 colorimeter and Kalman 2016 calibration software and did measurements. S7 Edge has 4 picture presets. Adaptive display as default option, AMOLED cinema, AMOLED photo, and finally basic mode. I measured grayscale, saturation, and color space for each on medium luminance level, and this is what I have discovered. By default, adaptive display is not precisely set, with too much blue and oversaturated colors. Errors in grayscale arise with luminance of the screen, making colors less warm than they should be. Similar cases in AMOLED cinema preset. AMOLED Photo and Basic are better adjusted by default, with warmer colors and smaller errors in grayscale. S7 Edge accurately covers sRGB color space only in Basic mode, while in other modes color saturation is much bigger. I measured 96.9% coverage of DCI-P3 in AMOLED Cinema, which is pretty much the same percentage as on LG's E6 OLED TV. Still, for accurate color representation of content, I recommend staying with basic mode. As expected for OLED display, each pixel can be turned on and off, leading to infinite contrast of the image. Together with excellent viewing angles, this is a big advantage over IPS technology. On the other side, IPS still has an edge in terms of peak luminance and also ability to display bright image regardless of how much white content is on the screen. I've measured peak luminance of 300 nits when whole screen was covered with white and 362 nits with 25% window. This is clearly lower than 570 nits constant luminance as measured on iPhone SE, making S7 Edge not as good when used under strong ambient light. In terms of scaling, picture uniformity and dirty screen effect, S7 Edge performs excellent. Upscaling is great, edges sharp, and without any noise or stair-stepping effect. Readability of text is perfect, and there are no uneven areas of the screen that would be visible while watching videos or playing games. Gradations were not as smooth as on iPhone SE, but this was mostly visible only on test patterns, not with usual content. Overall, Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge is not as precisely set by default in terms of colors as iPhone SE, but with small tweaks in the menu, you can get solid result. Together with excellent processing and high quality panel, I can recommend S7 Edge for all kinds of applications. Thanks for watching.